All right, hey everyone. So we are now live. All right. I'm just gonna post on Twitter, let everyone know that we are now live. Earlier today, I posted this thing about on Taco Bell's 404 page. They have this gift of a taco falling, and now and then Taco Bell retweeted this, and now all I see in my notifications is people saying my life with that image. As my friend Kevin Geiser says, wow, that is your best tweet ever. Except it's cool, except it's people do not care about game development streams. They care much more about funny gifs of personified tacos, as it turns out. So, if you're making a game, something to consider. Taco Tuesday. Oh no, it's Wednesday. All right, yeah, but anyway, I am super excited about the what I'm working on, the tool that I'm going to share with you guys today. Let me just retweet it. Yes. Of course, it is also amusing because I was at TwitchCon a few weeks ago, and Taco Bell had a booth there. I don't know what that was about, but they had a booth, and I guess they were doing something where if you send them your game, you can win a Taco Bell gift card, and I posted this. So now I'm wondering, this should happen. Twitch tech question: does that happen instantly, or while video has delay? I'm not too sure which one you are asking about. Actually, yeah. Oh, does chat happen instantly? Yes, chat happens instantly. Even though that has delay. Yeah, even though when the video has delay. So yeah, chat is instant. So yeah, maybe that's not such a crazy idea after all. Anyway, I'm gonna lower my desk and sit down. I've been standing all day. Okay. All right. So, what is it that I've been doing? So, I've been working on tool. If you guys remember, hey, thank you for the heads up. Game dev stream. At least I am on the right channel. But yeah, I am now. That is updated. Thank you, Jet User. Save the scene. I'm gonna get some more coffee. Okay, I'm now back with coffee. Where did my coaster go? Okay. Alright, so basically what is this tool and what am I trying to do? If you guys remember, let's kind of get to some of this stuff. Where is that cube tree area? Cube and tree test area. Okay. So, hey Zentoid, welcome. I was watching someone else work earlier today as well. I have no idea. I don't think I'm gonna do that. Yeah, I am basically shooting cubes everywhere, so let me talk to you. Alright, here is this thing. Okay, anyway, we have this line. Okay, so if you guys remember these lines, they're very important. Now, the way they are made, they've been made up until now, is each segment is made up of a different piece. So you see all of these line objects, they're prefabs and they have to go under a line manager. That's how it knows it's one connected line. And basically what the way, and I had them in separate lines because I have this piece called the corner, and the corner you can choose whether you have to signify that it's a corner piece, and then you have to tell it whether to invert it or not, because you can see right now in this one here, the gap is on the right side of the corner piece. Here, the gap is on the left side, so I switch the material. And then if I wanted to sort of move stuff around, I'd have to basically just extend it up here. And that's, it's using the size of it to calculate how fast this thing should be moving, etc. The problem with this is that it is a pain in the butt to lay down. And if you want to make changes, like let's say I want to move this block over. First of all, I don't know why it keeps... okay, so say like I want to move this over. I need to like select this line, make it shorter, move it over. Anyway, I don't really want to go through with it. It's really tedious and it just takes a long time to do it and it's not fun at all. So what I decided to do was, you know, was like, okay, you know, we're going to be doing this a lot because we're sort of in that phase where the design of the game is set. I know what the game is about. I've got all the mechanics. We've prototyped them and I want to start, We're basically going from prototyping stage, we're done with prototyping stage, and we're moving on to game, full-on game development, where we're thinking about, we're in that final stretch where we're just making stuff, it's all about execution. And I don't want to keep doing this because it's really tedious. So I was like, well, what we'll do is we'll create a tool that does it. And David, he's been working on the tree generator tool, and I decided, well, you know, I've always wanted to learn tools development, so I'm gonna dive into that. And this seems like, and I always kind of need something to be working on in order to really learn something. So this seemed like a good challenge to tackle. So it's been a few days and I have made some pretty good progress. So yeah, the editor tool. So basically what I've got right now is, you can see I opened up this line drawer tool and I said start block placement. And you can see now I've got this brush and it's really cool because it actually changes based on normal. And what it's doing is it's setting, it just puts a block there. It raycasts to whatever geometry is in the scene where the cursor is and it puts a block. And the idea is that once I've placed a bunch of these, then I go for mesh and it uses those points and generates a mesh for the line. So that's going to be a lot easier to do So I've been kind of just slowly getting that. It what I did, and I want to give credit where credit is due. I actually didn't figure out kind of this brush thing on my own. I ended up the documentation for Unity Editor isn't great. I'll go over I'll show you guys the code I've got working, but I ended up buying this this tool called Mesh Brush from the Unity Asset Store. It was $10. It was for painting meshes, if you had a rock and you want to paint moss on top of it. Hey, LA Watson. Yeah, this is a very chill stream, and you want to paint whatever grass on it, then you use this mesh paint tool. And I actually didn't need 99% of the features. I just wanted to figure out how you would get the brush thing working. So let me just show you kind of what he has. I'm not even gonna use that tool, but so I basically just stripped out the stuff I really did need. Oh, do people say Lotson? Yeah, I actually have an offset. I'll show you guys in the code just a bit. So you can see window, where is that? Tools. Oh yeah, so paint meshes onto selected objects. So you can see this is the mesh brush one. It has a whole lot of stuff. You can choose how big you want the. So yeah, now you see it has this thing, and it allows for multiple. You can put multiple. You can put you can put multiple things to paint. It sets the mesh as static. It has this big help thing. You can do all sorts of stuff that I just didn't need. All I wanted was this brush. And you can see it also, you have to click on this object, right? It's if I don't click on it, that mesh doesn't come. So you have to click on this object and have this enabled in order to do it. And I was like, well, for mine, I don't actually need it to be on. I don't actually want to select the object, right? The difference between here is that when it starts placement, it actually happens to anything in the scene. Oh, right, because that one has that going on. So I'm actually going to go ahead and remove their component. Delete that. Okay. So yeah, it was doing both. So I wanted it to not be a script that I put on an object. I wanted it to be inside the editor window and to have it be in all different places. And then what's going to happen is what we do is we create a whole bunch of red blocks. They're inside a temp box holder. We form the mesh, which is actually sort of very similar to the mesh that we're using for the water. And then that forms a line. So first time watching a dev stream involving Unity. Yeah, it is. Yeah, so I'm just starting to learn tools development. I wish it's been something I've been wanting to do for a very long time. If you are just starting out, I would highly recommend taking the time to learn it. It can really speed up your development process. So let's open up this code. The key is there's just so much stuff that I don't need. Right, he originally had this, his thing was over 1,000 lines, and I've stripped it down to just about 200, 250. You don't have the lots. Game Maker. Yeah, if you, whatever tool works, right? I don't think there's, yeah, it really all depends on what you want to make. Right, so what are we doing? Okay, let me talk about this. I think I need execute in edit mode. Do I? start block placement. Okay, so yeah, I don't need execute in edit mode. That's if you are doing okay, so that's not needed. So yeah, you can see there's sort of like a lot of stuff that we don't need. We basically, you have to extend this as an extension of the editor window. This I can probably get rid of. There's a whole bunch of stuff that I'm like in the middle of getting rid of. All the, like, I had it working where I had the script on it, but then now I'm like, I don't need that. Yeah, this isn't needed. But basically what we do is we create a holder object. Okay, so this you do need. You need an instance of this window, right? There's a whole bunch of stuff we're gonna get rid of here. We have the holder object. The box of pain is that's the red marker cube that we're putting down. We create a brush object. Then what we do here is we initialize the brush. We set basic properties for the line draw brush. Now in mesh paint, they had all this like stuff you can change all these. I don't need that. You know, it's really hard to scope games. Like, I thought I'd be done in 3 months, and now it's been almost 3 years. This is important. This is basically saying we create this. This is a delegate, so when scene view is called, that adds that whatever is happening in our on scene GUI that gets called, which in this case is drawing this. It also mesh brush had like a delete feature, but I don't actually need that. Line drawer tool. We'll see. We just want to get the basics working, and then we'll tweak it from there. Because eventually, I also want to be able to. You should be able to delete blocks or start. Start in the middle of one if it's going line drawer tool, and then we also need to like attach all the necessary scripts to it, but right now we are just sort of trying to get the basics down. And this is right, so this is saying when brush is active, then this button is available to us, and then for mesh, so like, because I don't want you clicking on form mesh if you hadn't set any blocks. And then eventually what we'll do is you can only form mesh once you have at least two of them laid down. So anyway, let's kind of go back. We're just in the middle of cleaning everything. So let's kind of get back there, and we'll clean out the code some more, and I can talk a bit more about what's going on. So, because previously inside the editor tool, you sort of needed this line drawer brush. You needed an instance of it. I don't, once we're doing editor window, we don't need that. So, we don't need the script, but we're basically just using that to hold stuff. So we do have test rooms. The thing is, this is more, I mean, we're going to hopefully have the level editor. And once a level editor is there, then that's sort of like a massive test room. Right now, like, you could make this in the level editor very easily. That's okay, man. I appreciate it. It's good. I don't want like a totally empty chat room. That's what it is for. Okay, so holder object, we don't need that, right? So like if holder object is null, we create it. What the hell? I wonder if this, I have that here, that's... Good one, mangy eye. Oh, you know what? Right, because we want the incense. If the incense of this isn't there. Right, so there we go. I'm still getting all this Taco Bell stuff. All right, box to paint. Yeah, we can basically skip the instance of the brush. We don't need that. I also wonder if... Could I do this here? Then I think I wouldn't need this line. Famous. Yes. Taco Bell. I'm never tweeting anything about Taco Bell again. It's actually like really freaking hard to use Twitter now. Famous! Hold on a second, yeah. Okay, let's start cleaning this up. What? Sausage biscuit? That looks like a taco. Well, I did make the joke about Taco Bell. I did make this joke for those of you who are just joining us about Taco Bell publishing Manifold Garden. This was in September 25th, so it's all happening. Don't even, what? When do I even use the brush transform, eh? Okay, right. I don't think I actually need this. You know what, hold on a second. I'm just trying to clean this whole thing up. Just brush.transform. This should be window. Brush color, brush radius. Wait, we don't need to set these. These already been set. Oh, come on. I just don't like using those blocks as much. Okay. Yeah, it has block commons, I'm just not using it. No, it's because you can't do nested block comments, and then it's just a pain. Okay, so we have the... Why is this... We're basically just trying to clean up some really messy code that was written when I didn't know what was going on. That's the key code. We'll just need that paint. And this is our, we actually can just do brush delay. Can I make it bigger? I'm not actually sure what you guys are talking about. Can I make what bigger? Yeah, I also think I need to get rid of this slope thing. That's carried over. I don't think I actually need that. That's our box to paint. You know what? I'm gonna. I'm gonna leave this one here for now. Oh, the font in the editor. There, I think this is a little better. It's actually a little bit too big. What do you mean by round trip? By the way, if you're new and you're enjoying this stream, you should follow. All right, let's see if this is working. Okay, it is. Excellent. So the only thing is, these are not, hey, thank you, LA Watson. We need them to be part of a holder object. I'm sure there is a joke here. Okay. So, let's see here. Oh man, this is actually making it a little bit... Having the bigger font is like making it a little bit harder for me to read. But... So, this is... We don't need that. Create holder object. And when we place the boxes, they should get parented to... The block that yes, it should be window dot. It should get placed in the Okay, so I guess this is where I'm getting a little bit tripped up. So we create a holder. How am I? Where? Oh, so this is just late, and I've been not thinking too carefully, because I want whatever painted mesh to be, yeah. Hey, man. Change size to. This was for the locks. I don't know how to change the. Nah, I'm just gonna do this. Okay, so I know what's happening. So this is our paint function, right? And we want it to Ezio Auditore. Ezio. Okay, because I want whatever painted mesh to become parented to our holder object. And right now that isn't what's happening. So let me do line drawer, and I set placement. Okay, so first of all, our line object is not being created. So our placeholder object. So if that was stupid. Hey, I'm a big fan of course I know, I'm a big fan of Assassin's Creed 2. Not the whole series, but 2 is excellent. In fact, I've played it twice. Alright, so we have our... Okay, so yeah, see, now it's being created. We have our brush should also be parented to... Oh, wonderful. So see, now we are getting it inside our temp box holder. We should actually have brush be in I think this can be programming with the programmers. Like, why is it not? Three was really weird. It had like, for some reason, they always started you. You always had to do like 2 fast travel for every mission, and it just got really tedious. Okay, why is this not? Why is it not getting parented? That's the question here. Let's delete these 2, and we will say. Alright, actually we are getting some errors. So let's start with this. Oh yeah, everybody's been talking about Undertale, which I'm very curious about. Why do I even need to set the position of this? Yeah, the out of animus stuff is not fun. Although I am very curious about AC5, because I've some of the reviews say that AC5 is the most similar to AC2, and it does look like it has a lot of really cool architecture that you can climb up, but it also they also seem to have done like really strange stuff with the kind of some of the missions. All right, so we have it now. The brush, this is all inside temp holder. what we want to do is let's just start connecting lines with a whole bunch of these when we say like form mesh. Okay, so that is it. So we've got that now. Okay, so I don't know why we need this here. So, okay, let's start from the beginning. Basically, we want this when we hit P. So we don't need this line drawer MP, and I think we're going to start to get rid of that. Unseen GUI. Brush mode function. Yep. So the thing is, I don't think we need this. So I'm going to go ahead and comment this out. And if I don't have any problems, then that's all good. That'll get automatically deleted once you close it. Yeah, I think the way they do the conceit is so they can like have an excuse to have you go between different places. Because then otherwise it's just like random historic settings, which I'm totally cool with. Yeah, okay, you know what? We didn't need that. I also want to see them make a full game. Well, they'll probably not do a great job with it, but a full AC, because they had one set in China. But it was like they did like the 2D version of it. I think it for a full game, because it would just be kind of cool to scale that kind of architecture. But yeah, now I don't really like the direction that they've taken with the newer one. So yeah, we didn't need that slope stuff. We'll get rid of that. Eventually, what I do want is. Yeah, you know what? It's easier for me to try to figure out the math on my own. So we will just do that. So yeah, this is the mesh offset, I think. Someone was asking about it. Yeah, that's right. Oh, right, and also for the vision, right? The enhanced vision, because it's like, how else is your guy supposed to see all the enemies behind walls? Okay, so we didn't need that. So basically, when we paint, right, what we're doing is we instantiate the box. That's our red box. We grab the transform. We put the position, which is where the raycast hit point is. We rotate it so that it's looking at the rotation. Oh, so it is rotated towards the hit point. Land depiction. This is something I'm gonna. You know what? We're gonna get rid of this because I think it's gonna be actually easier for me to figure it out on my own. This is our offset. And then we parent it, because the thing is, I don't actually want to save the cubes. Well, I sort of do want to save them if I want to go back and edit. But for the most part, what I want is actually, we just want to save, like eventually what we're going to do is have a bunch of these points. And we're going to use two of them to figure out the because for the mesh, we would need the upward facing vector For UV stuff and for the normal and the other one. So yeah, we do need direction when we're making the mesh. I was actually neighbors with the Soma guys at E3. The game looks super cool, but yeah, I don't do horror game. So I might just want to watch someone else play it. But that game seems to be doing really well, so I'm very happy for them. But yeah, I mean, Amnesia was like a big hit. And then we parented it to the holder object. Okay, I guess you have to register them. Does this mean you can't undo it if we block this out? Huh. Okay, let's see here. Line drawer. Oh, interesting. We actually can't, you can't undo it unless you add this line. Very cool. So, that's that. Alright, so this is it, and this is where the offset is, so that's all very, very straightforward. Okay, we have this kind of cleaned out, so we're just doing what we want right now. So, let's look at, I do think I can get rid of this MP stuff. We don't need that. So we don't actually need a reference to the line brush paint. So you guys hold on a second. I'm going to be right back. I've been drinking a lot of coffee today. Talus Principle, I just got the DLC for it. All right, let's get back to this. So, yes, tools are important. I wish I'd spend more time working on it. So, let's just try creating a very, very rough mesh. So, as we're painting, what we should be doing is we should be saving. Well, first of all, let's get rid of all the MP stuff. So, yeah, as we're saving this, as we're creating blocks, we should be saving kind of points to an array. So let's just say like array of position points and their array of normals, right? Because we want the position point and we want the surface normal at each point we do this, and then eventually what we're gonna do is connect them. But actually, you know what the thing is? Something else is the next point should only be. Okay, this is where it's gonna get a little bit fancy, because I do. You see, right now I can just kind of place these like red blocks sort of anywhere, right? They should be aligned to a grid. They should be aligned to a grid, and they should be. Yeah, so first of all, these should be paint. Okay, let's see here. You're placing the box. Yeah. Okay, well, the box should be aligned to a grid to do. The other thing we need. So we need the box aligned to a grid. The other thing I want to do is have. Like, I kind of want there to be. Like, I actually sort of want to restrict this to. Like, I want to have an overlay of where you can place the next one. Let's see, let's catch up on this. Chat. So, LA Watson asks, the green and blue blend stuff in the editor are supposed to be. No, that is, well, so what it is I'm using Pro Builder. And I have these things. This is all vertex color, so this is not really. I mean, it's what I see inside the editor. The reason I have this is so I can see when two pieces are aligned next to each other. So it's more for me. It's in the editor. Once it goes into runtime, another material is applied. Yep, Benji, I answer that. However, the story in TTP is kind of bad fit for the game, where Soma it is deeply integrated. Ah, interesting. But does it blend? Hey, David Kilmer is here. Interesting. All right, so let me see what would be the easiest. First of all, let's get rid of the offset. Let's get rid of all references to MP, because that's just not needed. Okay, looks like we're good, so we can go ahead and remove this. Ah, yes. That is a good point, I think, that Garlando Bloom brought up, which is the. That's always the thing with puzzle games, right? It's like, so you trap me on this island and then just left, like, a bunch of tools for me to get out? Okay. MP. Wait, we don't have that. So you know what? Let's just go ahead and delete this. We don't need that. We don't even have this transform, so that's not needed. Yeah, that's not needed. We have the timer, we have the time storage variable. I'll clean up all this. We don't need this slope angle. Brush is active. Yes. When brush is active, we need to, when we're painting, okay, so we are here in the painting. Should be a line to do. Okay, you know what? We'll do this to do. Save position and normal to or lists. Yeah, I guess lists would be better. For mesh forming. I think you should not have a hint system in your puzzle game. I think as long as, once you have the hint, you start to rely on that as a crutch to get players along instead of looking for other methods to guide the player. I think it's like that just means you start to rely on the hint system as a designer, because you're like, well, if players aren't getting it, we'll add a hint. So yeah, I think what Garlando Bloom is doing, like, I think Cairo ends up doing that, where it ends up using the hint as, because some of the puzzles aren't that great. You know, like, The Witness doesn't have a hint system. I don't have a hint system. And I have a hint system, but by not doing that, it forced me to kind of use other ways to help the player. Yeah. Okay, let's see. Let's get the waterfall controller script. So the waterfall controller script actually has this mesh generating system, and we're basically going to use that. So yeah, I kind of spent the last week reading through this, and now I know what's going on. And basically, Chris wrote this. Where's his mesh system? Oh, come on, stop it with this Windows 10 update. I get it. Obviously, if I haven't updated now, I don't plan on doing it. Mesh drawing. Ah, here we go. Get waterfall mesh info. This is where the mesh thing happens. So, first of all, I'm going to copy this list. I think I need that to the what's the normal? So that's vector 3. Marker normals. Yeah, we'll say. You know, I'm really bad at this stuff. We'll say list Oops. So we want normals and we want marker position. Okay, why am I getting this? Okay, I'm not. So two things is, void, so on destroy we'll need to clear the list. Clear the normal and position list. And we'll need to do this if this is to do. And also when we click form mesh, we'll need to do that. So where the hell form mesh? Where's our form mesh? Okay, yeah. Once mesh is, oh no, wait. You know what, once mesh is formed, actually we need to save normal and position list to the line itself for future editing. Let's see, let me catch up on the chat. Looks like lots of good stuff. Yeah. Hey, Brandon Dyer, 64. A Linux fan. Wow, lots of good stuff. So Cairo is gorgeous, but the puzzles are so weird. Yeah, they're kind of hit or miss, some of them. But yeah, I do really like Cairo a lot. I think the witness attempts to solve this problem in a different way by being non-linear, yes. Hope they just train on the edge, because you can't make real puzzles without having some people just not be able to solve some of them. Very true. Tio de Torre says, why is it that a lot of puzzle games have like every fifth level that is three times as difficult as the previous? Yeah, well, that's because you want that curve, right? You want to kind of come up and down. I think that's just a very common pacing situation. You don't want to just like keep getting difficult. You want a reward after something. That's actually, Ezio Artori has a good point, and that's actually something that I've stayed away from. The locks, are you talking about Snakebird? Snakebird didn't really have a... Snakebird was like easy and then impossible. It didn't really have a difficulty curve. Yeah. Certainly Braid and Portal both did the snake curve well. Ha! Yes, okay, so we are talking about Snakebird. I just saw that in the chat. Great Permutator. Haven't played that. Yes. I don't think that is... I I don't know if that is unique to The Witness, though, Garlando Bloom's point about completion with a relatively small percentage. Of course, I haven't played it. I have to see it. 20s being more difficult than 30s. Okay, you're talking about that. Great Permutator. Infinifactory is perfect. Every game should be Infinifactory. I'm wondering how much is Zach Garth paying you guys to talk about Infinifactory at every possible opportunity. Once Mesh Swarm, we need to have save the normal. I think, but let's not worry about this right now. Let's just say delete. Alright, so first what we want to do is we want to align. Okay. Align position, right? So we're going to take. Oh, God. So we're gonna hand in a. It takes in a position and then so they should be. Oh man, I've totally done this before. Okay, we're this is not exactly how we're gonna do it. I just wanna see if this is working. What has been the most difficult thing to implement in Manifold Garden? Everything. We are. I think the world wrapping stuff is actually pretty difficult because we have the physics super consistent across all that. I don't know. It's like everything with everything. Water has been a huge pain, but it's like water is a huge pain because we have to do the world wrapping. So it's sort of all tied in together. Probably the systems then, I would say. Manifold Garden was the most difficult thing to implement, yeah. Okay, let's align this. How do you actually play it? For which I'm not going to be able to show it to you right now, just because everything, the state of the game doesn't allow me to jump into a playable version right now. Cause just because we have like broken scripts, but first person game. You can walk up walls and there's no death. You're solving puzzles, you're exploring, doing all sorts of stuff. Maybe you can do... What main Jedi said about using F keys is wrong. maybe MIDI controller, maybe not. I forgot what I'm doing. Oh, right. Align position. Oh god, this tool is taking me forever! Okay, look, we are aligning them to that. So actually what I want to do is... This is actually times four. If someone wants to start making a game, how much of the base mechanics of the game does one have to have already figured out before starting a project? Well, the thing is, you can't really figure out how to do it unless you started making it. So you do need to... I think your question is, you do everything you need a prototype, right? If you're just prototyping, you should jump into it. Hey, Ryoku the Slayer is here. Hello. So you should just prototype it. I think your question is more, when do you go from prototyping to full game development? And I think you want to have a pretty big, pretty clear slice of what the game is. Like, just as an example, I would say the first 2.5 years were spent prototyping. And now we know where the game is at. Right, so we're currently in that phase where we're going from prototyping to full-on development. The hell is missing? Why are these being drawn? Ah! That drawer tool, well, it's not done yet, but yes, it once it's done, it will save me a tremendous amount of time. The reason why it's taking so long is because it's actually like my first time working on a tool, so what's up with my offset, huh? Yeah, so this is it's quite similar. The key difference is we're not using the inspector, so you don't have to have a reference on an object. It's all inside the editor window. So it's not that bad. It is just a few things that you need to kind of keep in mind. Is this on a grid? You know what would be helpful is if I could see it. Yeah, like this thing should be aligned to a grid. You know what we should do is we should, yeah, this is going down the rabbit hole. Yeah, it's also my first time running this tool, so I think it's taking a little bit longer just because I'm not, like, I'm learning how to do it, and then we're creating this tool, but I think it's going to... No, what I'm gonna do is before I drop this red cube down, I'm gonna have like a preview box. Right, that's just because you can draw a solid disk and you can also draw. Ugh. Huh, draw a wire cube might be better. Right? Okay, I guess it's not called draw cube, it's cube cap. And your first thing should be zero? What the heck? What is that? Control ID? No idea what control ID is. Why is nothing for cube cap? Cube cap! That's because it's cube cap. That was brilliant. How is this not... ID, position, quaternion, float, size... Because F... There we go. Where's my cube? Where is my cube? Cube. It's attached to the handles? Are you saying, oh, it's this? Wait a minute, hold on a second. Wait, I'm so confused. Why is it not... Why would it be attached to the handles, whereas these draw wire discs are also always at the spot I just laid out? Right, like what the heck? Because it's like, I just want whatever draw wire... I don't understand why it would not be where... Because can't you set the okay, so see, that's what's weird about this, right? Because you do set the position, and we have the position of it to be the same as the hit point. Ugh, I don't want to have to do that. I think I can get away with this. What the hell, man? Why do I have to... Oh, God, this is annoying. So fucking confused. I don't actually need that. I'm just gonna do this. Yeah, this is so fucking stupid. And how do I... Pretty sure this is the JavaScript version. Please don't think less of me. So fucking annoying. Somebody tell me what I'm doing that's wrong. What the fuck? Is this even... Oh! fucking idiot. I am such a fucking idiot. Oh my god. Wow. I've been working inside line drawer brush editor script. Fuck. Well, that was... It's because I was trying to work in the wrong... I was in the wrong script! There we go. Wow. Okay. Hey, normally it works, except when you're an idiot. That was dumb of me. Think outside the script. Okay. So I don't actually want the block. It's I just want a okay, so we actually we the problem is that it's not bending to the normal. Fuck, man. I know. In the garage and into a shipping container? What are you guys talking about? Ah, okay, see, now there we go. This is what I wanted. So you can see it's all nicely aligned. Except the box isn't good. The box is blocking too much. Yeah, you know what? I should just fucking figure out how to do a, we can probably make this just a little bit smaller. Why have them on a grid? Because the lines are going to be on a grid anyway. So, yeah, we want it. It's the lines are going to be on a grid, and I actually want to align it to, like, eventually what's going to happen is these are not, I don't actually even want them moving off. Like, I want them fixed aligned. So, let's move this to 2. Right, so like you'll see here, it's like what, I even might actually make these a little bit smaller. Like, let's do it this way. Let's make them, okay, so now we do placement, right? So you can see it's like bam, 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 bam. Wait a minute. This is wrong. Hey, Wendrixo, thank you. Yes, you are absolutely right. It's just late. And I'm confused. Yeah, you know, we should actually just put this thing up here. yes, you are absolutely right. That's exactly what it should be. Little coloration of the corners on the screen, a surface effect or something, and is it additive? It is a yes. It is pretty much everything you see. A big part of the art style is all it's all surface normals. Yes. Well, so here's the problem is that I don't want it. It seems to be doing okay, right, so we would be setting up these points. Okay, got it. Right, so, okay, yeah, so I want the next one to be drawn only at the position where it should lock it to, yeah, I know what I'm doing. So, we need to set it to a cross. Hey, Ryoku the Slayer, you are going to announce your game this week. Oh, yeah, no, we're totally down for it. I actually, by the way, this on Friday, we're not going to do game critique. We're just going to do regular game development stream. There was a bit of a mix-up, so there isn't a game for that day. But you know what, guys? It is 10:15. So what I'm going to do is next week I won't be here. I have another event happening next Friday. But I'm going to end the stream here. So this is we're working on game development tools. So we've got it. Some more like what I want to do is like basically what I'm saying with this tool is that if I set a block here, I shouldn't be able to set the next one here. Right, you know, I should, if I set a block this, I should only be able to put it here, 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 or here. So, because it should always be straight lines from there. So that's what we're going to, I'm just going to try to power through tonight and get as much done as I can. Hopefully it gets done this week, but I will post it and 40 new notifications. I bet they're all this Taco Bell thing. Alright, whatever. We will end the stream here. And, yeah, my biggest, most popular tweet today, to date, is a silly GIF from Taco Bell. Alright, I will see you guys later. And thanks for stopping by. And if you like the stream, you should definitely follow.